Hello friends, welcome to Achieve IAS. How are you? I hope you are doing well. So friends, as you know that on our channel, we are covering the syllabus of UPSC Civil Services, and for that purpose, we have started multiple series on our channel that target your prelims as well as mains. So currently, we have 10 series that focus on your prelims, and we have one series that focus on your mains. What we do in these prelim series, we daily discuss 10 questions of one topic. So in this manner, we cover two topics daily, so 20 MCQs are covered, and we will continue to do so till 31st May. So why the date chosen has been 31st May? Because on 2nd June is your prelims of UPSC CSE 2019, and we will end this series only one day before your prelims exam. So today is the first lecture of art and culture, so let's see what are the questions of it. So first is, patola is a style of A. weaving popular in Gujarat, B. performing arts in Guruvayur, C. shadow puppetry popular in Marathwada, D. temple construction in northern India. So these are the four options, so we have to choose one option. So let me tell you friends that patola is actually a weaving that is popular in Gujarat. So it is done on basically saris, and it also has geographical indication tag, the Gujarat. It is popular in Patan area of Gujarat, so it has a geographical indication tag. So this is the explanation of this, that is, patola saris are a double ikat woven saris. So this is retail, and also similarly Andhra Pradesh has also its own style of this type of woven style, that is known as Budhan Pochampalli. So this is the explanation. So let's move on to the second question. The second question is, which of the following describes most the Thoni most appropriately? A. It is an ancient form of martial arts practiced in Kerala. B. It is an environmental conservation technique of the Guddas. C. It is a harvest festival celebrated in northeastern India. D. It is the traditional law making body of the Naga. So we have to choose the correct answer. So let me tell you friends that the correct answer will be C. It is a harvest festival. It is the harvest festival celebrated in the northeastern India. So the solution is C. So here is the explanation given. So it is one of the major festivals celebrated by Cheksang tribe, which is a type of tribe present in northeastern India. So this is premier festival of new harvest, and it is celebrated on 5th January every year. This is the explanation. So let's move on to the third question. The third question is, which of the following statements about temple architecture in India is incorrect? So we have to choose the incorrect statement. A. Nagra and Dravid are famous South Indian temple construction styles. B. Visara order was created through the selective mixing of Nagra and Dravida order. C. Panchayatana style of architecture was practiced during the Gupta period. D. All of the above. So we have to choose the correct answer. So let me tell you that we have to choose the incorrect statement, and let me tell you friends that A statement is incorrect. Let me tell you that Nagra is a type of temple architecture that is prevalent in northern India, and Dravida is a type of temple architecture that is present in southern India. So A is incorrect. So both are not of south, they are the examples of South Indian temple construction styles. So solution A is wrong. So here is the explanation, so you may see it here. And there are three types of temple architecture. So though there are also regional uniquenesses in each style of temple architecture, and the regional names also. And this Nagra style is prevalent in northern India side. It is a North India style. Dravida is South Indian, and Visara is Central Indian. So temple at Diyogada is in the Panchayatana style of architecture. So here option C is relating to Panchayatana style of architecture. So this is also correct, because this Panchayatana, why it is called Panchayatana, because the main shrine is built on rectangular plinth with four smaller subsidiary shrines at the four corners. So this is about your third question. So let's move on to the fourth question. Fourth question is, this Buddhist mudra is called the gesture of debate or the discussion mudra. It is a mystic gesture of Taras and Bodhisattvas in which tips of thumb and index finger finger touch, forming a circle, and all the other fingers are extended upwards. So the mudra is, so you have to choose the mudra. So there are different kinds of Buddhist mudras, so we have to choose it is a Vitarka, B Abhya, C Varda, D Shramana mudra. So let me tell you, friends, that this is a Vitarka mudra. So basically it is the mudra discussion. It is in this gesture. So simply this index finger and thumb, they are forming a circle, and these three fingers are upright. So they are extended upward. So this is Vitarka mudra. So Gautam Buddha, when depicted in this mudra, so it means he is debating some matter. So the solution is A. So learning is basically this, that this is Vitarka mudra, and Abhaya mudra is this mudra, simply like a kind of blessing or fearlessness mudra. So this is also characteristic of Buddha Sakyamuni and Dhyani Buddha Amghos Siddhi. So this C is, this gesture is called gift bestowing gesture of compassion or conferring boon or grace mudra. The arm is extended all way down with palm facing outwards. So this type of simple movement, so you might see he when you invert it like this type of mudra. So this is about this one. And D is the renunciation, D type of mudra, that is this Shramana mudra. So it is a kind of renunciation mudra. So let's move on to the fifth question. Fifth question is, consider the following about the Nataraja dancing posture depicted in Chola period bronze sculpture. So friends, Nataraja bronze sculpture that was made during Chola period, it is quite popular. So we have to consider certain statements about it. First, the dance is associated with the end of cosmic world. Second, Shiva has been shown balancing himself on his left leg and suppressing the demon of ignorance. Third, Shiva's main right hand is posed in Bhumi Sparsh Mudra. Fourth, Tirubhava depicted in the sculpture shows the birth of the universe. So friends, we have to choose that which of the following is correct. So first is before you, and these are the next three statements. So let me tell you, friends, that only the first statement is correct. The dance is associated with the end of the cosmic world. Rest all of the statements are incorrect. So the answer is, solution is D, that is one only. So second and third is second and fourth are incorrect, because it is actually the right leg on which Shiva is balancing himself, suppressing the apsmara and also the demon of ignorance or forgetfulness with the foot of the same leg. So this, with the foot of the same leg, suppresses the demon. So at the same time, he raises his left leg in Bhuja Gatrasita stance. So this, which represents Tirobhava, that is kicking away the wheel of Maya or illusion from the devotee's mind. So he has four arms depicted in this Nataraja, and the main right hand is posed in Abhyahasta, or the gesture suggesting, and the upper right holds the damru, his favorite musical instrument, to keep on the beat tal. So here is the figure shown before you. So please clearly look at this image. So this is his right leg on which he is doing balancing. So here is, he has suppressed this demon. This is demon shown here. So you can observe it. So this is demon basically. He is suppressed. So with this left leg, he kicks the kind of this ignorance and this Maya illusion from the devotee's mind. So here are his four hands. So in this right hand he has Damru, and this is Abhaya mudra of Lord Shiva, and these are the two left hands. So this is about your bronze sculpture that was prevalent in Chola period. So let's move on to the next questions. Next question is, which of the following most appropriately describes Turanas? First, A, calligraphy inscribed on interior walls of royal darbars. B, style of dome-based architecture introduced by Turks. C, collection of chinaras and petrodeuras seen in decorative works in Islamic architecture. D, gateways over two Buddhist stupas. So we have to choose the correct answer. So let me tell you, friends, that the correct answer is D. That is gateway to Buddhist stupas. So the answer is D. So basically, it is explanation is given here. So Turanas mark the entrance to a Buddhist shrine or to stoop or to a Hindu temple. So here this is about your sixth question. So let's move on to the seventh question. Seventh question is, with reference to the art and archaeological history of India, which of the following are associated with the reign of Ashoka? First, rock cut elephant at Dholi. Second, Lomas Rishi caves. Third, Badami caves. Fourth, Udayagiri caves. So we have to consider that which of the following is associated with the reign of Ashoka. So let me tell you, friends, only one and two are associated with the reign of Ashoka. Rock cut elephant at Dholi is basically in Odisha. So probably where the battle of this war of Kalinga was fought by Ashoka, and Lomas Rishi caves are in the group of caves there are a group of caves in Bihar. I can't recall their name. So this Lomas Rishi cave is also one of them, and it is basically devoted to Ajivika sect. So let me tell you that Badami caves is not in the, were not built during Ashoka's reign. So it was built during the time of Chalukyas of Badami, and Udayagiri caves were built during the time of Guptas. So third and fourth is not included in this. So only one and two are included. So the answer would be one and two only. So the solution is A. So here is justification. So this is this is Bara Bara caves, which I have told you now. This Loka Rishi cave is also in this group of Bara Bara caves. Let's move on to the next question. Eighth is, the first discovery of rock paintings was made in India in 1867-68 by A. Richard J.C. Atkinson, B. William F. Albright, C. Max Muller, D. Archibald Carlyle. So let me tell you that the correct answer is D. That is Archibald Carlyle. So here is the explanation, so you can see it. Let's move on to the next question. Ninth question, consider the following statements. First, the Shramana tradition based on the principle of Ahimsa was an essential component of ancient Vedic religion. Second, the Ajivika school believes in the doctrine of absolute determinism, arguing there is no free will. So let me tell you, friends, that the correct answer, we have to choose which of the above statements is correct. Let me tell you, friends, that the first is wrong, because Shramana tradition is actually the tradition that was prevalent in ancient India apart from the Vedic religion. It was a kind, they were Shramana tradition, all those movements that were parallel but different from Vedic religion. So it comes different traditions like Ajivikas, Buddhism, Jainism. So all these sects come under this Shramana tradition. Second statement is correct. The Ajivika sect believes in the doctrine of absolute determinism, that is Niyati, on the doctrine of Niyati, that is everything is preordained and nothing can be changed. And second statement is correct, but the first statement is incorrect. So the answer is B, second only. So here is the solution. Solution is B. So as I have told you, Shramana tradition, it refers to parallel religious movements that were separate from historical Vedic religion, and the Ajivika school is based on Niyati, doctrine of absolute determinism. So they consider, let me tell you, friends, that please notice this point, this is important. The karma doctrine was not believed, the Ajivika sect did not believed in karma doctrine. So they considered it a fallacy, and they thought that everything is determined by Niyati. So they also gave the theory of atoms like the Sheshika school, so in which they said that everything is composed of atoms. So let's move on to the 10th question. The 10th question is, consider the following matches of sites of prehistoric rock paintings with the state they are located in. First, Lakhudiyar, Odisha. The Camurian extensions, Jammu and Kashmir. Third, Bhimbetka, Madhya Pradesh. Fourth, Kapugallu, Telangana. So we have to choose the correct statement, correctly matched pairs. Let me tell you, friends, that the correct answer is third and fourth only, because one and two is wrong, because Lakhudiyar is in Uttarakhand and Camurian extension is in central India part, that is UP and Madhya Pradesh. But yes, Bhimbetka finds the paintings of of the period Paleolithic and Mesolithic period, and it is in Madhya Pradesh, and similarly Kapugallu in Telangana. They contain the Neolithic paintings, rock paintings. There are also other Neolithic sites in Telangana, like there is Tekalkai, name is given to that site. So the answer is third and four only. So the solution is C. So here is the explanation. So as I've told you, that Lakhudiyar is in Uttarakhand, and this second one, that is Camorian extension, is in central India part. So the answer is given before you. So friends, this is about today's lecture. So these are the 10 questions. So if you like the discussion, if you like the questions level, then please like the video and share it with your friends. And also friends, do ensure that you subscribe to our channel. And in case you want to subscribe to the PDFs of these MCQs, then you can contact us at this number or email ID. So friends, let me tell you that if you want to get the PDF of these MCQs, then certainly it will entail a minimum cost. Because after all, we also have to sustain ourselves. So in case you want the PDFs, you can contact us at this number. So this is all about from today's lecture. Thank you very much. Have a nice day.